Hi everyone, this is Mr. Richmond, and for this video I'm going to walk you through how to do your series and parallel circuits lab using SnapCircuits. So on our left we have a series circuit, on our right we have a parallel circuit. We have two resistors, or two light bulbs in this case, for each of the circuits. The easiest way for us to identify which one is series and which one is parallel is looking at the amount of pathways for electrons to flow through the circuit. So we know that electrons are pushed out of the negative terminal of our battery source, and this is a DC, a direct current. Anytime that we're using a battery, that means that it is DC current, meaning that electrons are flowing in just one direction. So they're coming out of the negative end, and anytime that we have one pathway for electrons to flow, we consider that to be a series circuit, and I'll go ahead and turn that on. And if we were to look at our parallel circuit to our right, again, electrons push out the negative terminal. One direction, still DC current. However, we have one and two pathways for those electrons to flow. So we have an individual pathway for each of the resistors or light bulbs. So let's turn that on. And one thing that you can probably notice pretty quickly is that we have brighter light bulbs in our parallel circuit. So let's go ahead and start collecting some data to support why that is. So first off, I'm going to collect some voltage data. So this is a voltmeter, and you can see that I have a lead wire, or one of these alligator clips, on the negative terminal and one on the red positive terminal. And if the needle falls in between, somewhere between here and here, and I happen to be on the 10 volts for the positive terminal, I'm going to be using that top set of numbers. So if you look closely, you can see a 10, a 15, and a 3. If I were to be on this 3 terminal, I'd be using the bottom set of numbers to record my measurement. Then 15, I'd be in the middle. So let's go ahead and get some voltage readings across R1, which is going to be the closest to the negative end of the terminal. So this is going to be R1 for my series circuit. And let's see what I get. So right now it looks like I'm just shy of 2 volts, so about 1.8 volts. And for R2, it looks like I am at about the same, 1.8 volts. Now let's go ahead and get voltage for R1 in my parallel circuit. And it looks like we have about an increase a little bit, so I would say we're at about 2.4 volts for R1. And then maybe a slight voltage drop of about 2.2 volts for R2. So now let's go ahead and let's get some current, or some amperage readings. And if you notice, I've got my lead wire on the negative end, just like I did for my voltmeter. And now I have three sets of numbers, 50, 500, and 5. But notice, if you look at our units of measurement, that we have 500 MA and 50 MA in the just regular 5A at the bottom set of numbers. So that means if we're at 50 or 500, and if I get a reading where the needle falls in between there and my lead wire is on the terminal of 50 or 500, I want to make sure that I convert from milliamps to amps. Otherwise, my Ohm's law calculations are not really going to work. So let's try 500 milliamps, and let's see if we can get some numbers that fall in between. So the important thing for you to know when you are measuring current in a series and parallel circuit, it's very important that you should be breaking the circuit. And we're going to be closing the circuit to get my amperage reading. If you're not doing this, there's a strong chance that you're going to burn out the resistor. So it looks like I'm just shy of 200 milliamps. I would say about 190 MA for R1. I'm going to go ahead and break the circuit for R2 and then close it with my lead wires once again. And the current flowing through R2 would be approximately pretty similar, so about 190 MA milliamps for R2. And let's go ahead and start collecting data for my parallel circuit. So I'm going to go ahead and break the circuit just like I did for series, and then close R1. And it looks like we can get a current that jumped up slightly to about 210 milliamps for R1. And then my last set of data for this lab is going to be getting the current reading for R2. Again, I'm going to close the circuit with the lead wires. And once I get that needle to steady, it looks like I have about the same number, the same value of about 210 milli.